Babu joins us now, Mannapuram Finance. Mr. Babu, good morning. Thank you for joining us. Walk us through what is happening in your business, especially the rural and facing business, because that's where the recovery and that's where the economies have stabilized and gold prices are high. So how has your business moved in the last couple of quarters, given that rural India started functioning, normalizing, and also gold prices must have acted as a trigger for them to ask for more loans and collateral?
So there is an improvement in the business as quarter by quarter we make it, and we are expecting something 12 to 15% enhancement during this year in the AUM. That is ensured almost for this time being, yeah. And then the business is coming normal. And you know, we initialized well before, it's not new. 2-3 years before itself, online transactions are enabled. And now that is giving big comfort to our customers, enhancing the number of transactions 3 to 4 times every day. Even in Sundays also, the transaction is 25% of the business is happening in Sundays. And that means without any interference from the staff or opening of the branch itself, the digital transactions are moving very fast. This is a major achievement we noticed. And our aim is to double current business to online, so that the current AUM is per branch is 5 crores approximately, which we are looking to enhance to double by next year. This is the strategy as far as the gold loan is concerned. In the other verticals also, collection is coming to normal, and it is improved very heavily. It is more than double than we can say in June, and it is coming to nearly almost in good collection, which will end up with nearly 90-95% of the collection during the this month. This is in the other verticals. Otherwise, things are moving very faster. Yeah.
Sure. Good to hear that. Right. What I wanted to understand really is, Mr. Ravindra Babu, that what according to you could be the big challenge right now? Because so far it is the gold financiers such as you and NBFCs which are dominant in this space. But what when banks also enter into gold loaning space, which they already are, but given the kind of AUM growth and the kind of loan growth that we've seen when it comes to gold loans specifically, banks as well are aggressively now entering as well as marketing in this space. Do you think that could pose a threat to businesses such as yours?
See, we are not at all focused on the bank's business. Our business is to convert from the local moneylender business to an NBFC sector, where we are giving all types of comforts to the customer, technology education to the customer, online transactions, facilities, everything we are providing to the customer to enhance the mobility of the fund to the customer 24/7. This is our target. So our target is not the banks. Banks are there since long time, but our customers are not banking customers. We are the middle class people or lower middle class people. I mean, these are the type of people we are handling. So we are enabling those people to come to the NBFC sector, especially with Mannapuram Finance, providing more and more comfortability in the transactions. And you know, with the cheapest method enabling, one day interest, it is 3 days interest. He don't have to, suppose he want the money for 2 days, he can online, he can connect it and get the money for 2 days and close it with 2 days interest. No other charges is imposed on it. So the customer is getting considerably good comfort on all transactions. This is what we noticed. That's why our digital transaction is improving very heavily. I very honestly say that it is 3 to 4 times some days than 1 year before the number of transactions in the system.
Sure. So would you say that gold loans will continue to dominate your product mix going forward for the foreseeable future at least?
Yeah, we are going to be dominating the gold loan structure itself. Because there was a limitation of the distances, etc. before. Now the customer can come one time, put his gold in the system, and he can avail and close his accounts at any time. It is just like a credit card to him. So this is enabling the rural people to come to the branches in numbers. We can enhance the total business to that level. This is why we are looking for doubling our current business by next year or the coming years.
Okay, so that gives us a good sense overall as well. You know, on funding, anything you'd like to share with us there? While pretty well placed, is there any credit cost guidance going forward? Any room for margin expansion?
We don't have any issue for the funding. Funding side, we are pretty comfortable. We have during the last 1 year, we could maintain long-term funding heavily, reduced to almost less than 10% CP. Before it was 35-40%, but this is reduced to the CP. And our funding area is very comfortable for us. And we have good credit facility already sanctioned, which is not utilized so far.
Okay, and the competitive landscape as well currently, how is that looking and how do you feel you're stacked up versus what we're seeing the banks offering, for example?
Understanding. Can you repeat, please?
Competition right now, the increase in LTV limit for banks, for example, does that... leading to more competition at this point of time? How are you managing to maintain your market share given that we're also seeing increasing competition there?
See, even in with this scenario, 75% scenario, our average LTV is around 65%, less than that one. So even we could not provide, even the customers don't want more than that one at present stage. It does not make the additional comfort for the banks also. I think banks will not apply that theory because we don't know what time the gold price will crash. We have previous experience also.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us this morning, Mr. Ravindra Babu, and sharing with us some perspective there. All right. Let's go across to Soumya. We've got